And well, Iran wants diplomacy but not talks with the United States. This was the overwhelming message from Iran's Foreign Minister Javad Zarif in New Delhi, from calling the U.S. leadership arrogant and ignorant to saying they were bedfellows of the Islamic State. WION brings you the key highlights of Zarif's combative speech.
When they assassinated a revered general in Iraq, violating Iraqi sovereignty, they thought, as Secretary Pompeo tweeted, that people would be dancing in the streets of Tehran and Baghdad. Actually, he picked up a small gathering of a few and tweeted that we rid the region of a whatever he want to call him, and then people are dancing. That showed two things, which are very dangerous. And when combined, it becomes even more dangerous. Ignorance and arrogance. And when you become an arrogant ignorant or an ignorant arrogant, it becomes a disaster, particularly if you have a lot of power. That has been fueling mayhem in the region. Who are celebrating the death of Soleimani? Not the ordinary people. In 430 Indian cities, they mourned his death. Two people are celebrating, President Trump and Pompeo and Daesh. You call them strange bedfellows? Not necessarily.
All right, Principal Diplomatic Correspondent Siddhant Sibal is now joining us live for the latest on this. And Siddhant, well, while calling the U.S. arrogant and ignorant, it seems that Javad Zarif has also made it clear that all the military operations in the Gulf, as far as Iran are concerned, are over. Yet he has some very, very nasty things to say in that very combative speech.
Well, yes, Bhairavi, today is the first day of the Iranian foreign minister's visit to India, four-day visit, and on the first day when he made a speech at an event in Delhi, his basic focus was on United States, how Iran sees United States as a negative force, but by and large he made it clear that all operations, all military operations are over. In fact, this has been conveyed through diplomatic channel. By that he meant through the Swiss embassy to the United States, that if after this the United States responds, there will be again a response by the Iranians. But talking about his India part, because he was asked many questions by the Indian journalist. Among the important one was the fact that does he see New Delhi's role in de-escalation in the region in the aftermath of the killing of the top Iranian general. He said that he does see a role, which is an important statement made by him. In fact, he met the Indian Prime Minister as well. We are waiting for the readout as well. Now, tomorrow morning, he will be meeting the Indian External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar, who also reacted on this escalation which have taken place, who said the Indian foreign minister said that India is watching the situation, and of course reiterated that New Delhi urges restraint by both Tehran and Washington. But of course it's difficult for New Delhi to choose between two friends, because United States is a close strategic partner, but also when it comes to Iran, India's key strategic objective of connectivity through the Chabahar port passes through Iran, not only the Chabahar port but also the north-south transport corridor. So the statement made by the Iranian foreign minister, every word was watched carefully. And of course, it is expected to make not only national headlines here tomorrow morning, but also making global headlines.
Right, absolutely. And of course, Siddhant, now going back to the point where he said that India is a big country and therefore should play a more important part in the negotiations. This is something that Iran has wanted in the past as well. How keen is India actually to sort of mediate between these two major powers that are also, you know, allies and friends of India, a very, very critical balancing act for the country?
Well, India, what I understand, would not like to mediate between Tehran and Washington, but India would of course, and has only conveyed to both sides, both Tehran and Washington, that they need to restrain. And of course, when it comes to Washington, India has told Washington that its crucial Chabahar project, that is not only important for India's connectivity, but also important for Afghanistan, is something that Washington needs to prioritize. We know that Washington has already given an exception to the Chabahar project from the sanction it has imposed on Iran. So this is something that New Delhi sees its role, making sure that its interests in the region and between both the two friends, Iran and Washington, remain. And for that part, India is keenly hoping that there is no further escalation. And of course, it's engaging with both United States. In fact, we have seen India is hoping for a visit by the U.S. President and with the Iranian Foreign Minister. We know he is going to Mumbai, also going to meet the Indian business leadership in Mumbai. So that shows how New Delhi is reaching out to both Iran and the United States.
Right, Sudhan, thanks very much indeed for joining us with the latest there. The Iran Foreign Minister here, Javad Zarif, and making some very crucial statements here in New Delhi.